lust, pride, hatred, ungratefulness. Just a few of the many characteristics I possess. For I know that in me, that is in my flesh, dwelleth no good thing. For to will is present with me, but how to perform that which is good, I find not. For the good that I would do, I do not, but the evil which I would not, that I do. Now if I do what I would not, it is no more that I that do it, but sin that dwelleth within me. Amanda, I just really want to be honest with you. You see, I'd go to church on Sabbath and I'd attend these church functions and I'd participate even. But I was never truly an authentic Christian. I knew that my relationship with God wasn't thriving, it wasn't growing. And when I'd leave church or when the Sabbath was over, I'd be a completely different person. My mind would be in a completely different place. And then every time that I'd come back into God's sanctuary, into his presence, I would know that I felt guilty. Something wasn't right with my life. If you looked at my life from my outward appearance, took a step back and looked at my life, I would look like a Christian. I would look authentic. But if you got really close and you looked at me on the inside, you'd see that I was all messed up. It was only months later when I listened to the Holy Spirit's cry for revival, for reformation, for rebuilding in my personal life. You see, the thing that really hit me, the question that he proposed to me was, how will I stand before God when I stand before God? Will I be found worthy in his sight? What would it be like to actually go before a court hearing and stand trial for all the sins I've committed throughout my lifetime? Handcuffed in chains, I was escorted into the courtroom, with the court session just minutes away from beginning. Then walked in the prosecutor. He looked like a perfectionist, a legalist, a man of the law. He seemed proud, arrogant, and aggressive. He carried stacks of files with him, records upon records of every sin I've ever committed in the past. My defense attorney was the next person to enter the court. He was here to defend the case on my behalf. But how can he proclaim his defense over a case I knew I was surely guilty of? The trial that will determine my destiny finally begins. The prosecutor states his side of the case before the court.
In my hand are records of offenses that he committed. First, pride of self, living in arrogance.
I couldn't bear it.
He shows
countless sins being read aloud.
He thinks highly of himself.
And hearing each defiling sin only increases my guilt even more.
Swearing. I know his mother didn't raise him like that. With the same tongue you praise your Lord and Father, and with it you curse men? I got it all right here on paper. Look at it. No, look at it! You've been living your life thinking you've got it all figured out, but I'm here to tell you, you've been living a lie. Your Honor, based on the evidence presented, I strongly affirm the defendant Eden Henry II guilty. It has come to that.
My reputation? Torn. My dignity?
crushed. Hope now seemed so distant and so unreachable. I felt like I was in the center of chaos, confusion, and darkness.
Your Honor, he doesn't deserve the death penalty. You see, I've seen his life, during the good times and also the bad times. But there's something in him can motivate him to be a better person.
I mean, with all I've done and throughout all my life, how could this person still love me for who I am? Even though I've turned my back on him so many times in the past?
I hereby affirm that Eden Henry II is innocent and be pardoned from his past transgressions.
Objection, Your Honor. Can't you realize this man deserves a death sentence? His sins are too great. There's no way you can prove this man's innocence.
Defense attorney, if you strongly believe in this man's innocence, what proof do you have?
And silence fills the room. And all eyes turn to the defense attorney.
As of the case of Eden Henry II, who has been charged of transgression of the law, I, the judge, find the defendant not guilty and pardon of all transgressions. Case closed.
Pardon through his blood? Forgiveness through his blood? And redemption through his blood? It overpowers the influence of sin and captivates the soul. That's what it did for me. Knowing that Christ has given me the gift of salvation, I now have a newfound love and respect for him. From this day forward, I give my life to Christ. And I will live for Christ. And I will share with the world what Christ has done for me. For when we were still without strength, in due time, Christ died for the ungodly. For scarcely for a righteous man would one die, yet perhaps even for a good man would one dare to die. But God demonstrates his own love towards us, that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us.